Welcome back, horror family. James Wan recently stated in an interview he wanted Malignant to be a love letter to horror fans, and without question, he succeeded at the task. It is campy, creepy, slightly funny, action, and self-aware in this bonkers amalgamation of a film. Off the heel, it creates an exciting atmosphere, making fans guess what the creature is behind the malevolent horrors throughout the movie, resulting in a payoff that makes Malignant desirable for a rewatch just to catch the clues that Wan left behind for us from the beginning. I know the film just came out, so this is a spoiler warning. I will be going into the backstory of the main antagonist and revealing major plot points, so you have been warned. We will begin with the tragic story of Serena May, who became pregnant after being raped as a young girl. She was forced to surrender her baby to the Simian Research Facility under the care of Dr. Florence Weaver. The baby was an extreme form of parasitic twinning. The main body, Emily, had a teratoma formation from the parasitic twin. Teratoma comes from the Greek words tera meaning monster and oma meaning monster tumor, a fitting explanation for the parasitic demon Gabriel. Teratomas are a type of germ cell tumor that may contain several different types of tissue, such as hair, muscle, and bone. Teratomas may be mature or immature based on how normal the cells look under a microscope. Sometimes teratomas are a mix of mature and immature cells. After many episodes with violent reactions and some deaths, Dr. Weaver decided to just remove Gabriel, the parasitic twin, in order to allow Emily, the main body, to live a normal, healthy life. They were able to remove 80% of Gabriel, but some of the teratoma in her brain, which Gabriel shared with Emily, remained dormant in her occipital lobe. She was adopted by the Lake family. She adjusted fine, but developed a violent imaginary friend named Gabriel, who was threatened by the Lake's newly arriving baby, Sydney. When Sydney was born, Emily was able to suppress Gabriel until a violent conflict with her husband caused Emily to have a concussion, releasing Gabriel. Now, what was Gabriel? Was he just an advanced case of teratoma resulting in a parasitic twin relationship, or something else? A real life instance similar to Emily and Gabriel was the case of Edward Morday, a 19th century English peerage who was born with a female face on the back of his head. According to unsubstantiated reports, Morday begged doctors to remove the demon face from the back of his head. No one had ever seen it speak, but Morday repeatedly lamented that the face would whisper obscene and threatening things to him at night, keeping him awake and terrified. It is not certain why doctors refused to attempt to remove the face if they were able to successfully perform the operation to begin with, but it was all too much for Edward, who took his life at the age of 23. In the film, Serena, Gabriel and Emily's mother, referred to Gabriel as an abomination, a biblical term usually referring to ill omens or unclean sinners. Emily specifically calls him the devil, and possibly we should take the woman's word who shared a brain with him. Usually with teratomas and parasitic twins, one twin is absorbed in vitro. What if a demonic entity latched itself on the tumor, allowing it to survive, permitting the monster tumor to form and develop strength, maybe even giving him telepathy and electromagnetic interference? Whatever Gabriel was, he for sure was unnatural and without question an abomination. Whether his malice was organic or supernatural in nature makes no difference considering the loss of life left in his wake. Did you see Malignant? What do you think of the nature behind Gabriel? Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. Please remember to like, share, and subscribe. Stay scared.